Good morning and welcome to the 18th meeting of SICASA Sergeant at Arms and my fellow members. Today we are here on our 18th meeting, and do you know one thing? The generation of our fathers, if you compare the generation of our generation and our fathers, you will see the difference. We are far more smarter, clever than our father's generation. And if you notice, our generation and the kids' generation, they are way far better than us. What is the reason behind that? Can anyone tell you what is the reason behind that? That is the wisdom of ages. That is because of the wisdom of ages. We learn so many things from our parents, grandparents, and the people of ancient time who were successful in their time. From those people, from the life of those people, we can learn so many things. From our historical books like Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana, and many other books, we can learn so many things. Today, I would like to share a life history of a sagacious woman of Nepal. She comes under the top 25 women entrepreneurs in Nepal, Rukmini Devkota, because I have learned so many things from her life, so that I would like to share the same story with you. She was born in a normal family and married. She was married to a prestigious and prosperous family, but because of some problems, they went into bankruptcy, and they didn't have. They were prestigious family, but now that time they went bankrupt. So because of that event, they shifted to far western part of Nepal, so that nobody will know them. Whatever they do, nobody will know them. And they started from the scratch. In the meantime, her husband left to another district for job, and she was alone to handle with one newborn baby and two more kids. She was in very difficult time, but she had a dream to become entrepreneur, and because of her dream, she went to approach the branch manager of Nepal Bank Limited. That time there was only one bank in Nepal, Nepal Bank, one commercial bank, Nepal Bank Limited. And the bank manager refused to give her loan because she didn't have any security for mortgage. And because of that, she didn't have any finance to purchase machines. She had some skills of knitting sweaters, socks, and woolen caps. So that was the skills, and she used that skills. She worked day and night with three kids. And one day, the same manager was going to nearby temple at 3 a.m. in the morning, and he heard some sound of a singing machine inside her heart. And he went, "What is going on there? Who is the person doing some work at this time, at 3 a.m. in the morning?" And he found the same lady. And after seeing that lady, the manager decided to give whatever the situation is. If she don't have mortgage also, or before this mortgage for me, he thought, and he decided to give loan to her. And after getting loan, she studied only till fourth class, fourth standard, and she came to Ludhiana. From somewhere she heard that we can get good machinery in Ludhiana for hosiery. And with that, 10,000 was huge amount that time, and she, with that amount, she came to Ludhiana to purchase some assets, and she took some semi-qualified engineers also from India to establish her hosiery. When she had no food to offer to her child, she was able to take loan from bank, and she came to India and purchased the machines. And she hired some 3-4 people to do the job. But in the beginning time, there was no money to pay salary to them, and the people left because of no salary. And she did everything by herself. For some month, she did everything by herself with a lot of effort. There were days in her life where she slept only 3 hours a day. And after that, slowly, because of her, if you have a dream, nobody can stop you, and you can achieve anything in life. So she continuously, she persistently kept on doing that thing, and the business started growing, and she was able to hire new employees. And once the new employees were hired, she started growing that business, and now she is top 25 woman entrepreneur of Nepal, chairman of Dhangadi Chamber of Commerce, and she is fighting for election for the position of mayor now. And she is none other than my aunt. And I have learned a lot of lessons from her. From my childhood, she used to motivate me and give me a lot of wisdom, what I have to do in life, and what is the value of time, discipline, dedication. I have list of things which I have learned from her life. She is always a motivating factor for me. And she has given me a lot of wisdom how to go ahead in life. Not only this, we can find many people in our life. Not, we don't have to go far away. We may have many people nearby who are connected to our life, from whom we can learn a lot of things. And that is the wisdom of SS. And by sagaciously, we need to choose what we want to become and what we need to do now. And at last, I'd like to share one of the wisdom by Gautam Buddha. What we think, we become. What we think, we become. What we feel, we attract. And what we feel, we attract. And what we imagine, we create. Now, with this, I'd like to call the enthusiastic and sportsman of our Shikasai Speakers Forum secretary to read out the minds of meeting of last meeting.
Minds of meeting, 17th meeting, 25th June 2017. Meeting started at 8:10 a.m. Mr. Sumar started the session welcoming every member. He urged everyone to keep their mobile either in silent mode or in switch off mode. He spoke on the theme of the day beautifully. Mr. Sagar started the speech on welcoming Chief Guest and G. Mr. Ramlal. He spoke on theme of the day relating to a story of a daughter. Mr. Vatsa, Mr. Gaurav, Mr. Balaji, Mr. Yogesh and Mr. Sanjay presented their speeches. All speakers spoke on Project One. All speakers did their best to present their speeches effectively. Mr. Komala handled the session beautifully. All members got equal opportunity to participate. Mr. Ramlal sir was the evaluator and he evaluated the entire session. He just suggested speaker not to use thank you after the speeches, not to gossip, and to address who has given you charge of the street. Meeting in 10:39 a.m. Back to President.
Now, I would like to introduce our master of ceremony for the day. Very cool and calm person, and he has already written his final and waiting for the result, and I wish him all the best. Let us welcome the master of ceremony for the day, Kapil Dev.
Thank you, sir. Education is not the amount of information that we put into our brain, which runs riots there undigestedly, said by the great all your life, said by the greatest person of the 19th century, Swami Vivekananda. We all have the habits of gaining or collecting so much information from here, there, anywhere, but we end up not utilizing most of it many times. So one should be sagacious enough or wise enough to know, to understand what should we retain and what we should not retain into our mind. So this is Kapil, master of ceremony of the day, welcomes you with a very good morning to one and all present here in the Sikasa meeting.
Good morning.
And I would like to introduce, today we have with us our chief guest and general evaluator who is associate with the IT company, and she is also associated with CA Toastmaster, CA Kavita Sanjeevar.
Today, good morning everyone.
Good morning.
Today I will be evaluating the entire session from the beginning to the end. And to help me with this, I have the team, a listener, Balaji Nayak. Could you please explain your role?
Good morning everyone, my name is Balaji. I am the listener for the today's meeting, and I will ask you the questions in the evaluation session. So you need to answer for the questions. Those who know the questions, just raise your hand. Don't say randomly, because of that we need to select one winner for that one. Back to
Sanjay.
Speakers, happy CA Day to one and all present. My role today is of timer. We'll be conducting two sessions. First session is of prepared speech and the butterfly session. In prepared speech, you're supposed to speak for minimum 5 minutes, maximum 7 minutes. As soon as you complete the 5th minute, I'll show you this green card, and on the 6th minute, this yellow card, and on the final 7th minute, I'll show you this red card. In butterfly session, you're supposed to speak for minimum 1 minute, maximum 2 minutes. And for some exceptional cases, you will be granted 30 seconds grace. And on the completion of 1 minute, I'll show you this green card again. And on the completion of 1 minute, 30 seconds, this yellow card. And on the second minute, this red card.
Kramerian Shweta J, could you explain your role?
Good morning everyone.
Good morning.
I am the grammarian for the day. I will check the usage of the words, the pronunciation, and how it is framed.
Our counter, Yagya. Could you explain your role?
Good morning all, I am the accounter for today's day. So my role as accounter requires me to note down the uses of fillers such as a, like, because, so that you know, all these kind of fillers I will be noting down, and I will be reporting at the end of the evaluation.
With this, I hand over the session back to
Balaji.
Now we are going to start with the first session of the meeting, that is preparatory speech. So, let's welcome with a huge round of applause, Mr. Surat Rawal. He has come to Bangalore from the Far Western Nepal, Bajang district, to pursue his chartered accountancy, and he has written his IPCC exams this May 17 and waiting for the results.
Wealth without politics, politics without principle, commerce without morality, knowledge without character, and pleasure without concern, and science without humanity, and worship without sacrifice. These are the social science given by Mahatma Gandhi. Good morning everyone, I am Surat Rawal. I am from Far Western region of Nepal, Bajang district. It is very far from Kathmandu. I was born in 1997, 23rd November, and I born in like middle family. My parents' occupation is farmers, especially, and they do the agricultural activities. I have two elder brothers. And I have four sons from my parents. My elder brothers also are educators, and they help me on my travels. One of the elder brothers pursuing the finalist chartered accountants. Another, my elder brothers recently have completed engineers and carpenters and working in there. And my schooling has started on Bazan districts. There is very problem from Kathmandu, there is very remote area to gain or to achieve the education. There is the problem to find any syllabus of our educational matter and our materials and things. But in spite of, I achieved the one of the foundation of the education from there. And then through my family, society's help and my elder brother's help, I have step by step and many years have passed. I attend the SLC examination. In Nepal, SLC examination is the one of the iron gate of Nepal. There is no. But it is. I feel easily. I prepared well, and I get the pass marks. That is 73% on SLC. But one of the interesting story on securing marks is that I have got only 51 marks on English, and then 93 marks on mathematics. I know mathematics has talents. I delivered my jokes to my friends. I have talents for mathematics by birth, but they are brave on that. That's the reasons only one that in Nepal, all educations are students through the as a Nepali language. Nepali language is our mother tongue also, and only one subject is English. And then I got the S scholarship for doing the plus two, and from higher secondary education boards, and I came to the Kathmandu. After that, I joined science system science, and there is one of the problem. All the subjects of the science are in English. That is a huge problem for me. The physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics, everywhere. I switched off my education 3 or 4 months, very difficult. And a terminal examination was conducted. But I was secured less marks. There is problems. And then my teachers helped me. After that, I improved my performance. After that, I got 66% on the 11th class. And then after 12th class, I got the 75% marks. After one of the my driving force only hard workings. After that, completing plus 2 level examination, I went to prepare medical entrance. My dreams only to be a medical doctor to serve the societies. But after that, I have prepared 1 year to achieve its medical scholarship, but I am unable to achieve. That is very not interesting things. And then my elder brother is doing pursuing the chartered accountancy. He deliver every idea about business and every idea about the chartered accountancy. I am very interested at that times. And then the environment influenced me. And then after that, I interested to join the CEOs. After I passed the certificate, and I am pursuing the IPCC results. But one of the things which causes me is financial problems. And then I have a dreams to achieve to get the financial response. And then it is my dreams to the society is to increase the financial literacy to the society and to achieve alone, to connect the low level persons and then those persons which have no financial literacy, I want to connect on the global economy. That's my dream. And then I am doing this out of accountancy. It is a very renowned profession. And then it is better. And then another is I am interesting. I am staying on the Bangalore. It is better way. Thank you.
Thank you, Surat, for your wonderful speech today. Now I would like to call upon the stage who is pursuing his articleship at Manohar Chaudhary and Associates in first year articleship. He is a very good football player and his hobbies are to reading books. Let's give a round of applause to Mr. Tarun for his first year.
First of all, I have a very happy good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Second man, sir, and Mr. Kapil. Thank you so much, everyone, to give me this golden opportunity to present myself in front of you. I didn't tell you my name. My name is Tarun Multani. Naam to sunai yoga. So, before going to my introduction, I would like to tell you a small boring story. Everyone likes a story, no? No one likes a boring story. So, we'll listen to boring story also. So, a story starts with the voice of a crying baby. It was all about 20 years, 2 months, 7 days, 10 hours, 15 minutes, 25 seconds. So, the story starts with the voice of a crying baby. The voice was coming from a hospital of Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh. And the big brother took that baby in his hand and called him Bittu. And the first voice came from the baby is the Bha, and that means big brother. The baby born and brought up in a very simple family. Father is a director of a manufacturing concern. Mom is a housewife. And brother was 6 years old. Now he is a software engineer in the Bangalore. So he born and brought a very simple family. When it came to his studies, till the first class, he was number one in the class. No, from the last. It was a very hilarious thing that he was not getting first rank, but his family, everyone, his cousins and all, everyone was at the first rank in the class. Well, now they shifted to a small town called Panna district. There, unfortunately or fortunately, maybe because of some silly slavers, some easy slavers, he got a second rank in the class. It was a shock. Everyone was like, how he got the second rank from the last rank? But the problem is, a very famous thought is there. Once you get the taste of the success, no, you'll get addicted to it. 7 years down the line, it was not only the one time when he got down to the second ranking. That was the thing. After that? Now the kid is a teenager. Now the problem is starting. Now it was all boring. So after that, he got distracted. But still, from when you tasted the success, when everyone has a pressure on you to get the rank, to get a good marks, the teachers, the responsibility, the prestige in the school gets him to the very little marks, second, third rank, that's all. But that was a big thing for him also. After that, when the time came to selecting a career, when everyone is asking to which subject I need to select, he went to his father and asked, "Papa, what will I become?" Actually, from 12 years ago, he was sitting in a car. He found it very comfortable, that the car is very comfortable and the driver is also so comfortable. He spends half of the life, 12 hours of his stay in his car, and he's earning also. So what's the problem? He's a good man also. He thought that I will become a car driver, cab driver. Everyone just laughed at that time. After that, maturity came, and when he asked his father that what will I become, his father told, you're a sensitive man here. You can't do engineering at all. You are not able to do engineering. You are very sensitive. This is not your cup of tea. But the question is, what will I become then? His father knows that the child is ambitious. Now teenager is very ambitious. He wants to do something great. So the father told that you will become a chartered accountant. And from here, the next phase of the story starts. Now he has a good dream. That's a big dream of becoming a chartered accountant. From the next year onwards, he started to studying and he started to go to the how to become a chartered accountant, all the phases from the first BU onwards. But as everyone knows, there is a beautiful thought in economics: when you can't handle your success, you better be ready for failure. And the same thing happened. He came down to a very low percentage in the second BU also. A lot of distraction and everything happened. Next onwards, he tried to left the city. Unfortunately, he couldn't. But after that, he left the city whenever he, as soon as it was possible. He came to join the CPT. CPT got cleared by very good marks. Actually, the comeback is always stronger. So, but it is little bit tougher also. This time the result came, everyone was happy. But this is the only guy crying. The result was such a bad for him. He tried for 195 or something, but he got to 180 only, 180, that's all. So he was like only the guy crying in the side, in the room. After that he changed his city again. He came to Bangalore. Now the thing is, he has started his dream. He has took the first step to his dream. Now he is in the Bangalore, he can do anything he want. But still, the comeback is always stronger, as I told, but it is harder too. It is that much harder. The boy was very good in his studies and all till the 7th month. But as you know, it's a very common story, it's not like some special story. So the common thing happened, that is depression. And in the last 2 months of the IPCC exam, he didn't even open his books. It was very simple. Last day before the exams, he told that, hey man, do whatever you want to do, but do after 15 days. Leave these 15 days for me, that's all. Last day, one day before the exam, he was studying, and at last he cleared his first row. Second row he couldn't clear by the 9 marks. So that was all about the story. I can see so many questions on all your faces. Yeah, so many questions are there. So Dan, what is that thing that he came, that he back to the field again? The first question. Second question, who is he? Where is your introduction? Correct, no? So, the step he has taken is the 15th Sikasa student forum. He is back to the game now. And the story is my best friend. And I'm proud to be my best friend.
Thank you, Taru, for your beautiful speech on Project One Icebreaker. It was nice to hear about you and your brother's story. And now, I would like to call upon this stage the man who is pursuing his articleship under BT Satisar, represented Bangalore ICA twice at regional level in elocution contest, waiting for his CA final results. And the most interesting part is, he is a very good singer. So we are looking forward for a beautiful music today. So let's welcome with a huge round of applause, Mr. Imani.
Hello. thank you, Kapil, for such an enlightening introduction. I didn't expect you would actually talk about singing also. Okay, anyway, so where should I start? See, everybody is talking about how many years and days and months. Let me keep it simple. I was born 23 years back. And of course, 25 days, I suppose. Okay. We're in a very humble and simple family. And I'm proud to be their son. In fact, they are more proud that I'm their son. So it works both ways around. So I'm happy, they are happy. Well, if you ask me where I was born in Kolkata. And the reason being, my dad was posted over there. My dad is in Indian Air Force, so you know, he keeps on transferring from places to places, and that's why it has been a privilege for me to see a lot of places. I was born in Kolkata, then we went to a place that is in Rajasthan called as Mount Abu, that is a hilly area. Then we went to Chennai for 4 years, then we went to Shillong, which is again a hilly area, and then I'm over here for the last 10 years in Bangalore. There are many things. Some are called as facts in my speeches, some are called as interesting things, or some could be stories. Let me not share some facts or figures, or let me not share some stories. Let me keep it simple by making it interesting. When I was born, I generally feel if I'm the bigger brother, it somehow gives me an advantage, because if I have a younger brother with me, I always have the opportunity to take the leading role. And yes, I was lucky enough to be the elder son, and I also have a younger brother who is doing engineering right now. When I was in Kolkata, things were really crazy for me. Like, I didn't have any idea who I am, who I was, because of course by the age of 5, how much we can learn. Moving up, when we went to Shillong, Chennai, and I completed my 12 classes in three different states, having different kind of languages like Tamil, or if I go to Eastern India and go to Western India, it is a combination. So I couldn't learn any of those languages. The reason being how much I have stayed over there, 3 to 4 years every place. But the most important thing happened when I was in Chennai. I started my school career being with Chennai, and that was the most important thing. I got a really good teacher. Her name was Shashikala. She was so intelligent, and she was the one who has put me on the right track in my life. If I seriously feel till today, if she was not over here, I would have never achieved what I have achieved till today. I mean, the way she speaks English, the way she has the knowledge, the way she is communicating, the way she teaches us how to learn and how to understand things, it's amazing. That has given me the boost. And then of course, my mother, my father, and my younger brother all have helped me a lot to grow faster. Moving ahead, when I came up to my 10th class, there comes a dilemma between what should we choose. Because commerce and science both look right to us. The reason being, people who go into science, I mean, I'm a tech savvy. I realize that I can work much more technically and much more mathematically instead of working much more into a course like MBA. But eventually I realize how great it can go. Because of the lot of people who are already over there. And at the same time, I had a little eye problem which could, you know, somehow come into my career, because, you know, there will be suppose I'm into doctor, or if I'm into a scientist, or if I'm an engineer as well, like chemicals and, you know, all those small operations. I thought becoming a businessman could work out really better, and that's where I thought, how should I take up commerce in such a way that it helps me being into science and then being into a business. And therefore I always keep myself tracked with what is happening in mathematics, science. I always keep reading those books, but at the same time my career really lies in this course. And therefore I completed my 11th and 12th really bad, because I didn't get good students. Generally what happens in Kendriya Vidyalayas, it is always like the good marks students will definitely get into science, average people will get into commerce, and maybe little less than average will get into arts. And that became the problem for me, because I had scored around 9.2 CGPA, but I had landed up in commerce because of my own interest, and there was almost no one other than me who had taken up this step. So I didn't get a good environment, and kind of it somehow messed up. But then I decided I won't do BCom, because in BCom I realized I might find, you know, people who are not really interested to be great, and therefore I didn't even apply for BCom. I took a chance, I wrote CPD, and I waited for the results. The most fortunate thing is I got exactly 100, exactly 50%, not 99, not 101. I can call it as my luck, or I can call it as maybe by chance, but it's a good start. Then the life took on. I mean, I went into CPT, I met really great people. IPCC I went, and in IPCC I met a lot of new friends from different colleges, and they were all so awesome, and I made so many friends. I cleared one group in one time and another group in another time. Joined BVC. I joined BVC just because I had a friend over here, otherwise I would not have joined that place. And then moving ahead, in articleship also, I've already spent 2.5 years. I have learned a lot of things in different aspects, especially in terms of audit and taxation. And most important thing which I've understood is, when we read books, we don't get much, but when we do practically things, we actually get how things are, you know. I just read something like, okay, this is how I'm supposed to do. But the problem is, when I take that into practicality, there will be hundreds and hundreds of things related to it which I will have to take up and understand before I can solve a simple problem. And therefore, that is most important thing I learned. After 2.5 years of articleship, I somehow decided to be into this SICASA forum. And yes, it seems I have taken up a great initiative, and it will help me out a lot, and it will definitely give me a different aspect to cover up in my life. If you ask about me, how I want to be in future, basically I want to be independent. I have friends who are trying to be independent, being opening up businesses, and at the same time I feel the same. If I can do that, maybe around 35 to 40, I'll be in a position to not just demand, but to command. And at the same time, I'll be in a position not just to serve as an employee, but to make others also serve the country by being an employer to the same. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Imanshu. It was a very nice speech, though you didn't fulfill my promise for singing. Now it's time for break. So now we are in another session known as butterfly session. So I would like to call upon the stage Mr. Manoj Thaman for the butterfly session.
Thank you, Kapil. President, MC, and all my dear friends, very warm good morning everyone.
Good morning.
Today, I am here as a butterfly season master. Now, I will be giving you a topic, and it is your duty or your opportunity to speak on that topic, whatever you like. For example, I will give you a small topic, and then you have to explain about that topic, whether the advantages, disadvantages, or your views, or whatever you like, but you have to speak minimum 1 minute. That is the main motto of this session. In our practical life, we don't know when we'll get these kinds of questions. Suddenly, if someone asks one question, then we'll be like, what to tell now? We will not have a correct answer for that. So, for preparation to face such situations, we are conducting this session. Now, without wasting any more time, I'd like to give a first topic. What are the tricks you use to wake up early in the morning? And this goes to Komala Kethi. Please welcome her.
Tricks I use to wake up early in the morning. Usually everyone do that. Keeping alarm and mobile. Even I do the same. Other than that, when we sleep on the bed, comfortable bed, we sleep more hours, we fail to sleep still more. So during the exams, we need to sacrifice our sleep. So what I do is, I sleep on floors. that makes to wake up early and don't make us lazy. So that's the trick I use. Or else I will tell any one of my friends to wake me up. Then usually I don't eat more at the while sleeping. That makes us to wake up early. And then can sleep early, sleeping in the early, and we can wake up early. So these are tricks. That's it.
Thank you, Ms. Kamala. I think you got some of the tricks. Like eating less before sleeping, yeah. Or sleeping early in the morning, early last night. And main thing is our alarm. This is alarm is the biggest weapon which I use to wake up early in the morning. Now, next topic I'd like to announce. The world is a smaller place these days. It goes to Dipendra Thebe. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause.
Nowadays, there are a lot of populations growing on, and due to different global warmings and all, also the environment around us are sinking, and due to global warming, now water level of our world is growing higher and higher, and according to some research, Maldives, the nearby country from India, will be sinking around in 50 or 60 years, they are saying. So we can say world is becoming smaller.
Thank you, Dipendra, for sharing your opinion. The world is a smaller place these days. Now, the next topic. Slow and steady wins the race. I would like to call L. Prasad to speak on this topic. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause.
Very good morning to all.
Good morning.
Today's topic is slow, steady became a success. This is exactly correct what the topic given to me. If you take very shortcuts, then our success is in very short. If you take in a right route and right path to your success, it will give a long time for long study to your success. So today I would say your studies. So everyone plan, and today talks are very related. Wake up early, only so small, and to study. See, everything is very correct. Now I will start. Everyone starts studying at evening and morning to make their success in their life. Normally, all it says we will study at night at 4, 2, 3, 4. But it's better to wake up at morning and study slowly, because in the morning your brain is very free and it will think faster and fresh, and no thoughts will come to your mind while you are studying and doing the things. So, world is small today, nice, because everyone imagines the world is very small in our imagination. At the same that imagination, they have become now smartphones. So in our smartphones, we are seeing everything what happened in each corner of our world. So I would like to end this session with this and back to our MC.
Thank you, Prasad. Now, going to the theme of today's day, wisdom of ages. On the same topic, I would like to give a topic. Which story will you tell to your future child? For this topic, I would like to call A. Mahesh. Please welcome him with your topic.
Which story will you tell to your future child?
morning to everyone.
Good morning.
Which story I would like to mention? Every grandparents, they will used to tell to her, to their child, is like moon stories. What moon stories? I also would like to say moon stories and all to my child parents in future. And how I am becoming in future, how I am being positioned in the future, I would like to say how I am becoming that person in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Mois. Now, one of the wonderful session of our Sikasa Speakers Forum. We are going to have a break for 10 minutes. 10 minutes breakfast, and after this, we will continue our butterfly session. Welcome back after this beautiful break. Now, I would like to request Mr. Yogesh, who has chosen the topic, the theme of the day, Wisdom of Ages, to explain about this theme for today. Please welcome Mr. Yogesh with his round of applause.
Hello. Hello everyone. I see the theme for today is Wisdom of the Ages. Well, the theme itself is self-explanatory, that what we learn from our elders and what passes on from generation and how we take it ahead. It's like a waiting in the marathon and how we take it ahead to the end. Well, when during a childhood, even our parents keep telling us, like, beta, do this, don't do this. There are strict rules kept sometimes in the family that you have to do these things. And even probably when you're behaving with someone else, you have strict rules there also. Not only in behaving, what you really need to do in life, we can probably take this wisdom from the generations behind, probably because there's one good saying which I have at least learned. That's one thing which people always say, learn from your mistakes. I guess it's really wrong. It's better to learn from others' mistakes. That keeps your life at a faster pace. We also heard that slow and steady wins the race over here. But once you already have an example that other person has already done it, it's better you're on a faster track, learn from someone else and move ahead. So Wisdom of the Ages is it's a very important topic today. I want to change the mindset what we have, that we have to follow what is already defined. But it is not. Gautam Buddha also told once that when you have something, when someone has told you something, or your parents have told you, or the elders have told you, don't just listen to them directly. It is up to you. You have to be opinionistic over there. Wisdom is something which you take it, but doesn't mean you have to follow it. You have to analyze it yourself. That is seriously what we say. With your wisdom and intelligence, you have to analyze it. That's just the Wisdom of the Ages topic today.
Thank you, Mr. Yogesh, for choosing this wonderful theme. And I'd like to share one wisdom of ages. Like, today I chose one of the topic, like, slow and steady wins the race. Once my teacher, even same like he explained us, like, we have to analyze whatever they are saying or whatever they have told us, and it depends upon us whether to follow it or not. My teacher, he said that slow and steady wins the race, and immediately he added that this was told by our elders, but now if you want to win the race, if you race slowly, is it possible to win? No. It means slow and steady doesn't win the race, but fast and steady wins the race. That is what we have to analyze and we have to apply in our life. So thank you, Mr. Yogesh, for choosing this wonderful theme for today. Now, let me continue our wonderful season, this butterfly season. Now, I would like to give a topic. Why should we be active in sports? To address this topic, I would like to call Mr. Sisi Rizal. welcoming you to a huge round of applause.
Manoj, my fellow members, so why to be active in sports? Why? I think everybody knows why. Any answer from the audience? Why?
To be healthy.
Yeah, to be healthy, to be active.
And
be
strong.
To enjoy, to be strong, to get refreshment, to enjoy your life, to gather with your friends,
to celebrate.
So, sports is a important aspect of our life. Generally, what we do, we see a people, we enter in the CA field, we will leave our sports activity behind because of the study stuff and other things. It is an important aspect which we should have a continuity in our life, which will help in our health. Like going in the old age, you might suffer a health issue because of not having a good sport or a good running, good health. So sport is an important thing.
Thank you very much.
Obviously, sports is very important. And yesterday we met one of the eminent speakers here, and he's already 90 plus, but still he is very active because he was very active during his past. Like even in 75 years old, he was taking part in wrestling. And it was amazing, like with 75 years, how someone can do these kinds of things. We're totally blown away. And sports, really, it's very important to keep us fit and healthy. Now, moving to the next topic, how do you manage your stresses? How do you manage your stresses? For this topic, I would like to call Tony Thomas. Please welcome him.
Stress is the most important thing we all face, because exam days last 2 months or 1 month before, we don't know what we are studying. And the thing that I'm not able to manage stress at that time. And how I am managing stress, I need to answer. Yeah, sometimes I will walk simply through streets at all, looking here and there. All these things I will do to manage my stress. Another thing I am doing is through praying. Sometimes prayer gives us lots of stress free. And sometimes our friends can understand that we have some stress and some problems. So they also help me to reduce my stress. That some words they told me at that time also reduce my stress to a low level. One experience I can quote at this time is that on the second time when I am writing my IPCC, first exam is accountancy. We all prepared to score in 100 out of 100, and I also done for that. After exam, I understand that I will get at least 40. So I am in deep stress. But at that time my mother told me that you continue with your studies. Don't worry, you can cope up with other exams and all. And I studied that wedding that my mother told me, I forgot at my 8 or 8:30 in the night. So that wedding, she told me that tone and all filled me to get lots of relaxation. After that I had studied, and at that time I had cleared my first group. These are all the ways I manage my stress. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony, for sharing your valuable ideas how to manage your stress. Now, I would like to give a topic, your favorite singer and song, to Ajit Kumar. Sorry. I would like to give this topic to Ajit Kumar. Please welcome him.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Ajit and I am 18 years old. I would like to share my favorite song. It's Shape of You by Ed Sheeran. I know it looks sort of taboo to talk about this, but honestly, I just love it. It's seriously very good. And if I have to tell that somebody is making me helping me relieve my stress, it would be a shutter. If I have to talk about my other singers that I like, those are Linkin Park and One Direction. I sometimes listen to Arjit Singh too, but love is too mainstream. I'm not sort of the guy who just loves to flirt or just talk to somebody. I'm not the one who actually wants to greet somebody with a boom. I'm sort of silent, shy kind, introverted. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rajiv Kumar. Now, next topic. Tell something about your favorite TV program. For this, I would like to call Srinidhi K. Kamal. Please welcome her with you.
My name is Srinidhi and I'm an IPC student at VR 1 group and I'm awaiting results of group 2. I'm also doing CS executive. And a movie, as TV serial, I really, I'm somebody who watches a lot of TV and I watch all languages, English, Tamil, Malayalam. And I watch a lot of serials. Yeah, I know most people don't like serials, but I do watch all these, you know, daily soaps. I love those. My favorite TV program is Castle. It is a kind of like a detective story. There's a detective and there's another author and he goes around with her and that is very interesting. Each day they have a new episode and a new case they're going to solve and I find it really interesting. It's very fascinating for me. Then I like a Malayalam serial called Chandanavada. That is a remake of what is that? Thank you so much.
Thank you, Srinidhi K. Kamal. Now I'd like to your next topic. Whom do you take with you when you go for shopping? And why? For this, I'd like to call Farkandanas. Please.
Next topic.
Okay, I'd like to give our next topic. Friends are important for everyone. What do you think about it?
Friends are important, but my friend, my childhood friend is very good. Her name is Karishma. Now she got married. She stays in Tenali. Now marriage ho gaya na, to Ballari. I was there with her 1 week before, from 1 week before her marriage. That time we had a nice time. Now she has a baby, Aisha. She's also my friend is very beautiful, but her husband.
Topic. Importance of blood donation. To address this topic, I'd like to call Swetha Zain. Please welcome her to the show.
Importance of blood donation. To be frank, I have never donated blood till now. Actually, whenever I have gone for blood donation, I was always underweight. I mean, 50 kgs is the minimum that the kgs you require to donate blood, and whenever I have approached, they told I am underweight, I cannot donate. Now I can donate. I have told my friends days back that I wanted to donate, but then I didn't get the opportunity to give. So I'm just looking forward to donate blood. And then the importance of donating blood is that it is benefited for us as well as the person receiving it. For us, because the flow in our body, the new cells are generated, because of which we get fresh cells, which is very good for our health. And then the other person is benefited because he's receiving the blood what is not available, might not be available. So you are donating it and you are getting receiving it on the other hand.
Thank you, Ms. Sarita. Now I'd like to give next topic. One of the most important thing which you learn from your grandparents. To speak on this topic, I would like to call Malasri T. Welcome her. Please down.
Happy morning, friends. In my home, we have grandma, but last 15 days, we left her. It is so sad because like she has so much of ideas. She is telling so many stories. She is telling what her experience in her life. It is going to motivate us anything. Because they have such experience. Like when she died, so many people were telling what she done and before. Like she is putting for the cows like water, and she is giving like a button to n number of people there. When she died, so many people are telling her about she has done so many things for the people. Like nowadays no one going to do like that, but because she was with us, because whenever my parents are fighting or anything, she is telling like not to do these things, it is not good for the family and those things. Like she is giving us small examples. I like to learn so many with her, but when she died, I was so sad, like anything. Like when relation people came, she something give to her, like she keeps something to herself, so she is sharing with us. Like, and the thing is, she is telling so many proverbs. When we also don't remember such thing, also she is telling so many songs. And then nowadays we are not going to see her like her. And my grandpa, like my grandpa also same thing, like he also done so many things, because we have so much agricultural land, there's so many people are working with him. And now when he died also, like there's so many people are telling like your grandpa done these things, you have to carry forward the same thing for your next future also. And because like we have to carry forward what they have given a message in our life, we can also take the same success in our life. Thank you one and all.
Thank you so much, Manasvi, for saying your everything. Now, I'd like to give next topic. Whose place do you visit often and why? To speak on this topic, I would like to call Jaya Kumari. Please welcome her to the first round of applause.
Which place I visit more often? In Bangalore, I have not visited much places yet. No, I am not doing articleship, so I am not even visiting for that. If I talk about the most, the place which I visit most often is Jayanagar. Because I have taken my classes there. I know that place, the surrounding more better there. When I went to, like when I have to catch some bus, it's near to my PG, so I better go to Jayanagar and take the buses also. When I go to visit my brother's hostel, I have to go from Jayanagar. And if I talk about the place which is not local to Bangalore, I visit my grandparents' house. That's the only place which I keep visiting. Like I have visits 10, 12 visits in a year. Only the I have not visited anywhere from past 2 years. I am staying in Bangalore. I have planned for Mumbai, Goa, Hyderabad, but not yet. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Jayakumari. Now, the final one. The topic is, what do you prefer, living in a city or in a village? To address this topic, I would like to call Shivam Tiwari. Here's a round of applause.
Strictly to the answer the question which I got, I don't like to be in city as well as to be in place. I would prefer in between the place where not in place too. Yes, I'm from village background. There we have faced a lot of problem like educational institution, hospital mainly, main problem is we have to move little bit far. It's roadway connection also is not developed too much, might be a problem. Then last time while analyzing myself and I was projecting the future, then where to stay? Is city good? According to the profession, we have to prefer city. We have to have a lot of clients and the things, opportunities to get. Blaze is not bad. Then I just came to conclusion that it would better be little bit behind city. That's what crowded will be less. Then don't be in too much blaze. Opportunity we might lose. Then be in such a place that we have the opportunity to stay peaceful life. That's all about. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Tiwari, for giving this wonderful speech. Now, I'd like to call, first of all, I'd like to give a topic, electric shock experience. To address this topic, I'd like to call Edgar Curry. Here's a round of applause.
Butterfly session master, Mr. Manoj, and fellow members, electric shock experience. Luckily, I have not had huge electric shock experience, but if I have to share my childhood experience, when I had a desktop system at our house, so whenever we had some problem, it used to accidentally, your leg used to touch that CPU. So there, the cover, we had taken it out multiple times, maybe because of that reason, whenever it used to touch that, some small shock would come. So that is one electric shock experience which I have had in my life. Sorry, that is one electric shock experience which I have had in my life. That's all.
Thank you, Yagya, for sharing this wonderful electric shock experience. Now, with this, I would like to conclude this butterfly session and hand over the session to Master of Ceremony, Kapil.
Manoj, for the wonderful session. Hope everyone enjoyed the session, as everyone got the opportunity to talk in some different topics for the short time. Now we have completed our 2 sessions for the day. We are in the last session of the day, that is evaluation part. And so I would like to call upon the stage CA Kavita ma'am for her valuable evaluation for the speaker.
Thank you, Master of the Day. Hello, Toastmaster. Good morning once again.
Good morning.
Fellow speakers, good morning once again. Today, may I request a timer to please read out the time.
accept something.
Good morning once again. In prepared speech session, Himanshu spoke for 7 minutes 17 seconds, Tarun spoke for 7 minutes 48 seconds, and Surat Rao spoke for 6 minutes 50 seconds. Let's have a big round of applause. And Mr. Yogesh spoke on theme and he spoke for 1 minute 56 seconds. And in case of butterfly session, Komala spoke for 1 minute 9 seconds, Dipender 1 minute 15 seconds, Prasad 1 minute 27 seconds, Mahesh 56 seconds, Yogesh, Sisir 1 minute 5 seconds, Tony 1 minute 57 seconds, Ajit Kumar 1 minute 10 seconds, Srinidhi 1 minute 8 seconds, Nas 58 seconds, and Shweta Jain 54 seconds, Malashri and 2 minute 17 seconds, Jay Kumari 1 minute 36 seconds, Suman Tiwari 1 minute 29 seconds, Yagya Gir 37 seconds. Now I'll call out the names who are who cannot be represented here. That is, first is Mahesh, because he has spoken for less than minimum seconds. 56 seconds, Mahesh, Nas, and Shweta Jain. They are not eligible. Please don't vote.
Once again, good morning to everyone. I'm the listener for today's meeting, and I'm going to ask some questions from the prepared speeches. The questions are, those who know the answer, please raise their hand first, then I will ask them. Okay. The first question is, name of the entrepreneur mentioned by Sagar in his speech.
Rukmini.
Okay. From which place Rukmini purchased asset? At what time 17th meeting was started?
8 a.m.
And in Surat speech, how many percentage did he got in 10th class?
78.
And how many marks did he got in English in Surat speech?
31.
In Tarun speech, currently in which firm he is working?
Chaudhary.
Full name.
Manohar Chaudhary and Associates.
And in which hospital Tarun was born? From hospital village name. Yes.
Yeah,
Jabal Hospital.
It's from
Jabal.
Place.
To which place Tarun shifted for second class? Which district? To which district Tarun has shifted? How many marks did Tarun got in CPT?
5.
185.
In Himanshu's speech, in which place he born? In which place he took birth?
Kolkata.
From how many years Himanshu staying in Bangalore?
10 years.
Okay, that's all the questions. And the winner is Jay Kumari with 3 votes.
Grammarian Shweta Jain, can you share your report?
Hello everyone. The states that I have noted down is she had dreamed to become entrepreneur. It would be she had become, instead of became, it will be become. And then in the beginning time, she faced a lot of difficulty. Instead of in the beginning time, initially she had faced a lot of difficulty. Habits of gaining should be habit, not habits. And then one of the speakers, he has addressed, if you are addressing any one elder brother, you should use elder brother, not brothers. One of my elder brother. And then, marks on mathematics, it will be marks in mathematics. And then, hobbies are two reading books. Someone when have asked introduction that it will be hobbies are reading books. Problem is started, it should be problem has just started. You are not able to do engineering, it will be you will not be able to do engineering. And then he tried to left the city. It will be leave the city, not left the city. Some usage of words which can be betterly used. Housewife, instead of addressing your mom as housewife, you can address her as homemaker. And then he went to his father. Instead use he approached his father. And then some more things were, result was such a bad for him. You can use result was not satisfactory. And then keep myself track with science, it will be keep myself updated with science instead of track with science. That's all.
Our counter, Edya, can you please share your report?
So, I can say that it is the power of 18th meeting of Shikasa Speakers Forum that I was not able to note down any fillers as such in today's role players talks as well as prepared speeches. There were few fillers in the butterfly talks, such as usage of well, like was used repeatedly. Then there is some awe was there in few speeches, but apart from that everybody were fluent in their talks.
Before I start my evaluation, I want to say that as I last time I requested that I wanted to come again, so I'm glad to be here again, and I really and thoroughly enjoyed the session on Sunday morning. It made my day. Thank you all. To start up the evaluation, a couple of points I want to first say is, like, all the speeches were good. The butterfly session was really good, though it was like impromptu. You guys did come up with good ideas in this short span of time, which was really good. The topics given were very good. We'll speak about that more when I come to the butterfly session. The meeting was started with Sergeant at Arms, Vasudev. Yeah. Good start. When you said good morning, the loud voice was good. You just got the attention of the entire group here. That was really good. Spoke about the theme. Stories were good. We are all, like, especially Indians, are known for storytelling. That was shown by you. Like, a lot of people, we are, like, born, brought up. From the day one, we'll be hearing a lot of stories. We inculcated that. So that could be seen in that. For you to improvement would be like you're moving like this, right? That's kind of a distraction. So restrict your movement, but you can still use the BRs, but just restrict that moment. And you had a good eye contact, that was good. I'm not sure what time you have taken, but I felt the time taken was a little long. So you want to restrict the time that you have used. And you need to reiterate to the group to use the word and the theme in the speeches and even in the butterfly session. Yeah? Job well done by Sergeant Atam. Next was President Sagar. Very good speech. I was motivated by the story. As it sometimes so happens when in life, as we grow, we think that we are the great, right? We have achieved everything. There is nobody else who can do more than us or more than me. When you share that kind of story, it's like, okay, there's a lot of things to achieve. So it's not the end of it. So that kind of motivates. That was a very good story. So Aki, you are lucky to have your aunt to inspire you. You had a good usage of theme and the word. That was good. You have a very good voice. So voice modulation can really take you further. When you started the story, the modulation was like little low, which was needed. But when you were explaining in between, it should have been gone up to the high pitch. That could have been really good. Yeah. Applause for. The best part next is minutes of meetings. As I said in my last time also, I really like that because that gives us an idea of what happened in the previous meeting. Shishir read out the minutes very well. It was all captured. I could get what happened in the previous meeting. There, if I have to add a point, like you mentioned about all the speakers talking about the speeches, you can say, you can pick a word or a phrase from each speech and say that that was a highlight, which was a takeaway from for others. That could be a very good past part of a minute. Yeah. Applause for then master of ceremony Kapil Dev, aptly dressed for the occasion, started the meeting very well. You did introduce all the speakers very well. You have a good eye contact, and you used the word for the day that was there for the. That's been specified for the meeting. Very good start. Good voice. You can just increase your voice modulation or increase your voice. It could be really good, especially in the morning sessions where we tend to Sunday morning. So you need to always keep them up, awake. So you need to use that loud voice in between. And one other thing is that you did capture some of the interest of the speakers, which you mentioned. That's a good point. One point for improvement, if I have to say, could be like you can try connecting the speeches and take it forward, the meeting. That's a role for that's a requirement for the role of the MC. Go to connect the speeches and then take it, so that the entire meeting is connected. So that you can work on. Job well done. Then coming for the session one, prepared speech. Project one. Who's the evaluator for project one? Yeah. Please give your evaluation.
Beginning, you were holding your hands like this only. Then the grammar notes are given by Shweta Van. Then you could say that attend the SSLC exam, attend it. And then at the last of your speech, you were looking down itself. You were not giving your eye contact. Then at the last, while leaving the stage, you have not given a handshake and you went down.
Suraj, you had a very good voice. You started a good voice and you had like different sentences and started with those sentences, which was good. You had a good eye contact in the beginning, which was like you had covered almost the entire room. That was really good. You had a good body language. Probably as you proceeded, that's where you lost that. You were like little taken back, the confidence level. Even whatever happens, even in the middle of the speech, do not worry. Just keep that eye contact going. You will be doing great. Yeah. And as she said, you were looking at the down. That should be avoided. Just keep the eye contact the way you started in the beginning itself. Yeah. Closure could have been little more. I initially, I felt you did prepare well. It was rehearsed. But probably in the end, I think probably you just missed out something and then you could not recollect, so you just wanted to close it abruptly. Like you did not close, you just left it abruptly, right? There you could just improve a little. Yeah. Otherwise it was good. Job well done. Applause for Speaker 2, who's the evaluator for Speaker 2?
So Tarun had a good lucidity, good flow of language. Suggestion I could suggest is like he has to improve in his posture, like he was doing like this sometimes. Not the end, but you were just standing under one leg. So that in all is avoided. You have to maintain a firm composure. And at beginning your eyes were to the ground, like eye contact was not proper. At the end you started looking. And at the beginning, even a smile was lacking on your face. That also came at the end. That should have been maintained throughout the speech. So, now few to add to the grammar and whatever she suggested. Engineer in Bangalore, would be he works as an engineer at Bangalore. And taste of success, no. No is not required. This we keep on adding this filler. No, that was not required. Sensitive person in the context was not clear. It was quite ambiguous. Ambiguous. What was bad for him that our grammarian already mentioned about that. What is that thing? Correct no. Again, this is the second time I am suggesting this. Correct no is not the proper usage there. It is the isn't it. You should tell like, what is that thing? Isn't it? So, sorry. What is that thing is different. This was also a filler kind of thing. This was also not required. It was not contextual. Correct no should be replaced by isn't it or other appropriate words like aren't it, aren't they. So like that. That's all. Thank you.
Tarun, you had a good humor. You started with the suspense. And I could see that you had prepared well, rehearsed well. That could be seen in your speech. You had a command over language and were speaking calm. The calmness we usually don't get. You were calm throughout. Somewhere in between, I think you lost it. That's where you were like looking at down or lost eye contact. And as I said, the good suspense was good. Like, that almost end of the day, end of the speech, everybody is like, what is he saying? Even if they've lost in the middle, the middle, the end, it's like, okay, he's going to say something. That's one of the good features for the speaker. Good opening, body you can say anything, whatever is one. Good closure is required. That was good. Only if I have to add to that, you said like I'm going to tell a boring story. It wasn't a boring story, it was a good story. I know if you wanted to create that suspense, you can say that, you can use any other words than boring. What happens when you put that word boring? Oh, it's like, okay, the insert is not happy sharing it, so let me not listen. Right, that feeling should not be given. Other thing is, you did not share about your entire childhood or what other things you did in your childhood. That I could not get. So you could have used more time, or like I think he still had time, right? So you could still use that and explain about your childhood. Other members in your family also would have been good things. Yeah. Big applause for. Who's the evaluator for Speaker 3? Himanshu.
You had a good flow, even a little faster because I imagine myself reading out the minutes here, the speed. You had a good voice, confident, comfortable with the stage. I had seen a smile on your face, which was good. A few times you were closing your hand, you were rubbing your hand like this. The movement was there, which can be avoided.
and I like the closure which you have.
I can speak a 3 months. Your body language was good. The way you narrate your story, that was good. I could get full picture of how you were, what's your family background, what you want to do, what's your strength of mixing both mathematics, business, and how do you, your perception on commerce, what are the difficulties you faced, those were all good. You had a good eye contact, you were enthusiastic, your speech made like, okay, though it's Sunday morning, it's like, yes, even I want to do something like that, I want to think out of the box. That's kind of an interest that gave to me. As evaluator said, you had a very good closure. From the beginning to the end, you had a good flow of thoughts, you had a good closure as well. If I have to suggest as an improvement, as a speaker when you are coming up here, if you dress up a little formal, I'm not going to say complete formal, like a business casual at least, then that will give more confidence for you to speak and you'll be taken more seriously by the audience. That's a suggestion for you. Job well done. Applause for So after prepared speech, we had this butterfly session. I know this session is literally a butterfly. It's like in the school we'll be like, okay, teacher should not call me now. I'm going to not see my teacher, I'll be looking around. That's how we feel here also in this session. But the session was very well handled by Manoj. He had a different topics, which was easy for the audience to talk. Especially the topics, the tricks to wake up. That kind of helped me. I have this alarm in my mobile, but there is another one which is called snooze. I'll keep snoozing and I won't wake up at the time which I'm supposed to. So that's not the right thing for me. Probably I should try sleeping on the floor if I have to wake up early. And sleeping early in the night, that could probably help. That was a takeaway for me for that. Other topics, shopping. I was like eager to stand up and share my because shopping is like interesting and we would always have talk, but still she managed with friends, that was good. And I could see that she missed her friends so much and she was emotional about that. It was good. And sorry about your grandma. But as you said, you have a lot of things to learn from her to carry forward. That's a good thing. In the butterfly session, though it is like you put across a question, they come and talk for 1 or 2 minutes, you can still make it more creative in this session. You can have some stuff packed like in the paper, ask them to pick it up, describe about that, or you can ask them to talk about anything. Like you just tell that, how to prepare a cake, how do you do it, though you are not a cook. Something like that to make it more interesting. You can even have small debate, group discussion, even those can be done during the butterfly session. You can make it as creative as possible. Yeah, that can give more interest to for the audience to pick it up. Yeah. Job well done. Applause to you. Now coming to the other role players, listener, Balaji Nag. He did capture good questions. I know it's a difficult role to play because like you will not be, though you won't have to concentrate there, you still have to pick up some questions, make a note of it and then ask and see, and he should know what the answers are. Otherwise it's like he can't judge properly. Job well done. Applause for Timer, Sanjay. Yeah, even that is a little difficult because he has to keep a watch of the time. We'll be carried away with the speeches and we'll lose out what time it is. This pause or the stop would not be hit. The time will go off. How do we make it up? That is what we will be struggling with in that role. But you did your job very well. One suggestion would be, as a timer, you need to keep a tab of time from the beginning of the meeting. What time the meeting started, what time sergeant took, President, MC would not be captured, but other speakers and the butterfly session. Yes, in the butterfly session, you need to talk at least for 1 minute if you have to take for the voting. the reason to have that session is to make you stand here and talk for 1 minute. So if you can just be blabbering something, but you just have to ensure that you stand here for 1 minute. That helps you going forward to take up speeches, which is like 3 to 5 minutes or 5 to 7 minutes. Yeah. Job well done. Applause for Samarian Shweta Jay. Aptly captured, not only capturing and also suggesting how to go about that. That's a good point. It's easy to say that, okay, this went wrong. But nobody would say like how to correct it. So coming up with those corrections, that's a very good job done. Applause. Our counter Egya, again, like as I said, since there was a sequence of meeting held, his job was easy today because he don't have to note down much. That's how his role is supposed to be. It means that all the other speakers have come up to that stage or to that mark. All job well done from Yagya. Overall, I really enjoyed this session. Thank you all once again. Have a good day. I now hand over the session.
Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable evaluations on individual speakers. And hope everyone will try to improve on the same areas which ma'am told down in the upcoming days. So with this, we are in the end of the session. So I would like to call upon the stage Mr. Sagar Vishal, President of the Forum, for his closing remarks.
First of all, welcome Srinidhi and Ajit to the Sikasa speakers family. Now you are the official member of our forum. Let us welcome them with a big round of applause. Today we had 3 prepared speech and butterfly session, and it went well. Financial literacy, Surat. I want to look forward to work with you in the field of financial literacy and financial inclusion, which is very much important in countries like Nepal, India. We need to cover a lot of places and bring them into global economy. And other speakers and role players also did a wonderful job. And one request for Sergeant and Arms, make sure that camera and breakfast is ready on time. So breakfast was ready, but today because of camera there was some delay. So come, whoever take the role of Sergeant at Arms, come a bit earlier and then make sure everything is ready so that we can start our meeting on time. And I hope there was no role of our counter today, it was very less. And in the same way, I expect there will be no role of grammar here in coming future. So let us improve on that field also. And thank you very much, Kavita ma'am, for your presence for the second time in our forum and for your wonderful evaluation and suggestions. And thank you everyone, everybody, role players and speakers, for your participation today. Thank you. With this, I would like to conclude today's meeting.